Hello, my name's McConaughey, and in this audio recording, I'll be sharing my thoughts on Avengers Infinity War. Before sharing my thoughts, I wanted to let all of you know that my novel, The Kane's Files, written alongside my brother Scott Moore, is available on Amazon for $8.99 on paperback and $5.99 on the Kindle. I hope readers will stop to take a look at our episodic crime mystery novel, and maybe even let us know what they think in a review on Amazon. It'd be very much appreciated. Cheers! Rabies and Germs, welcome to NJ Today. You're watching this on YouTube or on Mishmashers.com, and on this edition, I'll be sharing my thoughts on Avengers Infinity War, the latest installment in the Avengers series and the 19th installment in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. For those that haven't watched the Marvel films since everything began to come to fruition, Infinity War is arguably what the series itself has built itself toward, or at least it is part one of what the series itself has built itself toward, as I do think the follow-up to Infinity War and this film would be needed together to create a full narrative. Those who have followed the series have been able to watch as the pieces were slowly put in place, through mentions of the Infinity Stones and other ways they interconnected each film. Even if you're not a fan of the Marvel Cinematic Universe in general, whether you prefer the subject matter of, say, the DC Extended Universe, or you think that superhero fatigue has set in, what they have done in terms of scope has never been accomplished on such a large scale in the film industry. That doesn't inherently have to excite you, but it interests me. And I'm very impressed with the sheer quality of a lot of these films and the way Disney has allowed the Marvel juggernaut to take unique approaches. Avengers Infinity War is a 2018 superhero film directed by Anthony and Joe Russo, and written by Christopher Marcus and Stephen McFeely. The film brings forth an ensemble cast including Robert Downey Jr., Chris Hemsworth, Mark Ruffalo, Chris Evans, Scarlett Johansson, Benedict Cumberbatch, Tom Holland, Chris Pratt, Josh Brolin, and really, it's so many it could take half this review to name them all. From a box office perspective, as of May 22, 2018, Avengers Infinity War is pacing ahead of the first Avengers film from a domestic standpoint and ahead of Black Panther, although it looks like Black Panther will eventually pull ahead and stay as the Marvel Cinematic Universe's highest-grossing film on a domestic front, which is a testament to how well that film did. Worldwide, Avengers Infinity War has already become the biggest film in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Right now, it is on pace to cross the $2 billion threshold and could even potentially past Star Wars The Force Awakens as the third highest grossing film of all time, although it looks like it might not have enough in the tank to accomplish that feat. Nevertheless, unsurprisingly, the third Avengers film is a monumental box office success. The story follows the ensemble cast of characters, a range of superheroes ranging from the Band of Misfits and the Guardians of the Galaxy, the Avengers lineup, and newer additions like Black Panther and Spider-Man, all while the antagonist, a character named Thanos, has begun gathering all the Infinity Stones, powerful gems that grant omnipotence and omniscience to anyone who has them in their possession. Thanos' modus operandi with a completed Infinity Gauntlet is that he wants to wipe out half the universe, doing so because he believes finite resources and scarce living space can be solved by doing so. The film, of course, follows the cast of heroes with their intent at stopping Thanos from succeeding in said feat. I'll say early on that I liked Avengers Infinity War, and I am satisfied with the film we received. The progression and evolution of the Marvel Cinematic Universe has been distinctive over recent years, and at least some of it can be credited toward the Russo brothers. I enjoyed Avengers and Avengers Age of Ultron, but in my opinion, they never particularly succeeded as anything above mashup superhero entertainment. Formerly, this wouldn't be deemed as a criticism, but because of saturation and because how the stakes have been raised, and simply because how much better I believe the MCU has become since its initial phase, I think many of us wanted something more than that from Avengers Infinity War. The Russo brothers have succeeded at delivering a large-scale superhero ensemble Avengers film twice in a row now, their first being Captain America: Civil War. One of the biggest criticisms about the Marvel series has to do with its light-heart, zany, and silly approach. An approach that isn't bad, but is unfortunate because of what these films have the potential to be. Thankfully, something that the Russo brothers did with Winter Soldier and Civil War, and now Infinity War, is they have found a better, more proficient blend of those elements. Avengers Infinity War cracks a joke here and there, but at the same time knows when it is time to be serious, and those serious moments, not needlessly put in, are all the better for it. The film handles the cast of characters well, although I will say that none of the actual heroes bring the absolute best of what we've seen from them. I wouldn't say there's ever a moment in this film I was bored, but I would say that a lot of the characters that receive screen time, be it Vision, Scarlet Witch, or Gamora, are admittedly some of the characters I feel have been made to care less about. That isn't to say they themselves are bad, and I actually think the characters all played their parts well. In the end, as far as characters go, I think that what I'm getting at is, in regards to this film, is that while I think the characters themselves bring a lot of enjoyable, entertaining moments, I didn't see a whole lot of great moments from the characters. Maybe that's to do with the sheer robust amount of characters involved. Again, I don't want to suggest that anyone was bad in this film. I enjoyed being able to see Spider-Man, Doctor Strange, and Iron Man interact. I enjoyed seeing the Guardians, and I enjoyed seeing everyone else. It's fun Marvel entertainment. But it isn't anything very gripping for the most part, as much as it is enjoyable banter. Josh Brolin does fantastic as Thanos in this film. Although Killmonger from the Black Panther film might have been the first really good antagonist we've ever received from a Marvel film, I think that Thanos blows him out of the water with ease. A lot of this is because the amount of build to him, a lot of it is because the sheer amount he's allowed to do. But a lot of it is also because the performance and logic behind his character. The best villains, in my opinion, if they're not simply insane, is when they have a reasoning behind their actions, a reasoning that, while we can look at it and say is wrong, we can understand where they're coming from. History has shown us overpopulated areas and large amounts of people who have died from starvation, and while most of us likely wouldn't condone wiping out half the universe, when you're presented with everyone rationing out resources and dying, or half the population dying, with the rest of them being able to live, it's in that moral conundrum that Thanos is able to flourish. The scenes with the character are absolute gold, and I would actually go as far to reckon that Thanos is one of the best antagonists we've ever seen in a superhero film. The action scenes and special effects, as always with these films, are on point. The action in a lot of superhero films can oftentimes feel bogged down with quick editing and overt amount of balls being thrown in the air at once. While this film isn't innocent from the occasional mindless fodder, I will say that I enjoyed a great deal of the action. The film becomes caught up with giving the characters all something to do, and I think that's the curse of such a large-scale ensemble as this, but I also think that it has some moments I would consider as creative or inspired. Avengers: Infinity War checks a lot of the boxes in fixing criticisms had for a lot of the previous Marvel films. It delivers not only a good villain, but a great villain, as well as carrying severity to its situation, while at the same time, not overcorrecting into a dark, dreary, or dull aesthetic. The film, from the offset, carries the approach that character armor isn't as thick this time around, which has been a long-standing criticism. The film handles its characters very well, and although it might not deliver peak executions of each character, they're all solid through and through, able to keep too many from being overlooked while also keeping the film from feeling over-encumbered. It's a very well-made, very good film that I definitely recommend, and it left me excited for what will come hereafter. As far as rankings are concerned, I would easily put it over Avengers and Avengers: Age of Ultron as the best Avengers-titled film.